Today's appetizer calls for a semi-firm or a firm cheese, and there are many cheeses from Ireland that you can use in this farmstead cheese range for this recipe. If you go over to Limerick, you can choose from the Old Creamery range, or you can go up to Offaly and you can choose from Mossfield Organic Farms. One of the others, one of my favourites, is Cahill's, also from Limerick. But today we're going to go to my neck of the woods, which is County Cork, and I have chosen a cheese from Carrigaline. So for today's appetizer, we're going to make Carrigaline Beech smoked pastry shells. To start with, you're going to make your puff pastry shells. Just follow the directions on the box and they'll take approximately 20 minutes in the oven. So while your puff pastry shells are baking in the oven, let's get on with our crab apple sauce. Crab apples. Why did I choose crab apples? Well, growing up in Ireland, I was a little mischievous and at times was known to climb a few walls to steal a few apples. And then locally, we had a lot of crab apples growing wild in the woods. And that's particularly where you'll find crab apples in Ireland. Now, they're widely available over here as well. And they have a very tart, bitter flavor. But that earthy flavor from the apples paired with the beech smoked, you know, earthy cheese just makes a wonderful combination. And they're actually very easy to prepare, crab apples. So you're just going to stem them. Of course, you're going to wash your apples first. Stem them just slightly, and don't worry about them. This isn't meant to be perfect, you know? Nothing in nature is perfect. These are just pretty. And the skins alone have that gorgeous blush color. So you're going to take your crab apples. So I'm stemming all the apples, cutting them in half, like so. I need to prepare my Carrigaline Beech smoked cheese in two ways. Larger than bite-sized pieces, because it's going to go into the bottom of my puff pastry shell. And grated from a box grater, that's going to go to be added to my sauce later on. Now you need to take out your medium saucepan and add the water and the sugar. Throw in your apples and let's bring this to a boil. Once it comes to a boil, you're going to reduce the heat and then let it simmer. I would say from 8 to 10 minutes, but you can tell yourself, you know, if the apples look a little soft and mushy, then that's perfect, it's done. Turn it off and set it aside. Using either here, you can use a potato masher will work just as well, or a good food mill, which tends to remove the skin. And let's bring our apples through this. As you pass them through, the juices will come through. You may retain these later to make a crab apple jelly if you wish. So here with our medium-sized saucepan, and make sure that this saucepan is cold. You always add the butter to the cold saucepan. We're adding our butter, allowing it to melt, and then we're going to gently add our flour, stir it with a wooden spoon, give it a good old stir. Now with our warm milk, we're going to add this and whisk it until it's really smooth and glossy. This, we're going to mix in our grated Carrigaline beech smoked cheese and give it a nice stir until it's lightly melted. Well, here we have our Carrigaline pastry shells. Oh, these just look delicious, don't they? I'm sure you'll agree that these little tasty appetizers are one that are sure to make Anne and Pat Farrell extremely proud.